A relationship between inflammation and carcinogenesis has been appreciated for over 100 years, from the time that the famous physician Virchow recognized that cancer behaves like a wound that doesn't heal. However, the molecular explanation for this relationship has not been well understood. Nowhere is the link between inflammation and cancer more evident than in the link between inflammatory bowel disease and colon cancer. Inflammatory bowel disease comprises two diseases, Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis, and both of them are marked by inflammation of the gastrointestinal tract. When patients with this disease have prolonged inflammation of the colon, they are at increased risk of developing colon cancer compared to the general population. The incidence of IBD and colon cancer rise as nations industrialize, and this suggests that changes in diet may contribute to colitis and colitis-associated colon cancer.
Sphingolipids are highly conserved lipids found in animals, plants, and fungi. The fact that they are so ubiquitous means that they are found in many of the things we eat. Although sphingolipids from different sources are structurally unique. Gut epithelial cells are exposed to bioactive sphingolipid metabolites generated by the breakdown of dietary sphingolipids. One such metabolite called sphingosine 1 phosphate, S1p, a breakdown product of mammalian sphingolipids, is known to promote inflammation, cell growth, and tumor progression.
S1p is degraded by the enzyme S1p lyase, which is highly expressed in gut epithelial cells. To learn more about S1p in carcinogenesis and inflammation of gut, we developed a conditional knockout mouse that completely lacked S1p lyase in gut epithelial cells. These enzymes have high levels of S1p in the gut, so it's a good model to study what S1p does there. We compared the responses of the knockout mice and the control mice to a chemical-induced model of colitis-associated colon cancer. Compared to the controls, the knockout mice exhibited much more inflammation and higher incidence of tumors. The tumor size was not increased, but there were more proliferating cells in the intestinal crypts of the knockout mice, which told us that S1p was not affecting tumor progression, but was acting at a very early step of carcinogenesis.
One of the downstream effects of S1p is to activate a transcription factor called STAT3. We found many signs of increased STAT3 signaling in the knockout mice compared to controls. When we pretreated mice with a drug that inhibits STAT3, the knockout mice developed much milder colitis and fewer tumors. This result told us that S1p promotes inflammation and carcinogenesis through a STAT3 signaling pathway. Using cell culture experiments, we then showed that S1p signaling causes a cascade of events, including activation of STAT3 in two STAT3 activated microRNAs, which themselves led to the silencing of two tumor suppressor proteins. Importantly, these changes promoted the ability of cells with high S1p to grow at a faster rate, to form tumors in mice, and to acquire characteristics associated with tumor cells. This change, called cell transformation, is one of the earliest and most fundamental steps in carcinogenesis.
In contrast to the cancer-promoting effects of S1p, we found the soy or plant-type sphingolipids, called sphingodienes, cannot be metabolized to S1p, and instead enhance the metabolism of S1p in gut tissues when fed to mice. Further, oral sphingodiene treatment reduced inflammation, many of the pathological signs of inflammatory bowel disease, and the incidence of tumors.
To determine whether our findings in mice are relevant to human IBD, we then performed gene expression analysis of IBD patient colons. We found that the colons of pediatric patients with IBD had higher expression of S1p-related genes compared to controls. This indicated that even at an early age, IBD patients have an increase in S1p signaling.
In this study, we have shown that dietary sphingolipids may promote or prevent colon cancer depending on their structure and specifically on their ability to be metabolized to S1p. sphingolipids that are derived from mammalian sources can be converted to S1p. And through S1p, they drive inflammation, cell transformation, and tumorigenesis. In contrast, sphingolipids derived from plants and soy are not able to be converted to S1p. They inhibit inflammation by reducing the levels of S1p and thereby reduce inflammation-associated colon cancer.